The Alpine skiing world has brought the top student athletes to Whiteface Mountain, located in the hamlet of Wilmington, New York, just 10 miles or 16 kilometers from Lake Placid. Hi everyone, Sandy Caligiuri here. Privileged to be with you over the next week to bring you the World University Games ski racing in Super G, giant slalom, the Alpine combined, and the mixed team parallel. Today, on the Thruway and Draper's Drop Trails, it's the men's Super G to kick this off, followed this afternoon by the women's Super G. The four runners around the course, as you can see them, the weather has really been the story, not only of these last couple of days, but those that are in the ski industry in the Northeast, that's really been the story of the entire season. As we take a look at the weather now, folks are riding the cloud splitter gondola up to the top of Little Whiteface, and here is our temperature. It's really a nice day to ski, not only if you're racing, but if you're just out enjoying the sport in general, recreationally. And the combination of Thruway and Draper's Drop is the trail that will be used here. It's 1,400 meters in length. It drops 415 meters. And I can tell you from personal experience, a lot of that 415 meter vertical drop is right at the start. This course gets everybody's attention. Here's our start list. The top 15 on the fist points list are drawn randomly. So this was a random draw last night of the top 15. And then from 16 to 49, the end of the field, it is according to rank. As we go immediately to Albert Ortega of Spain. A 24-year-old, he did ski on the 2021 Spanish World Championship team, so he knows about big events. A little bit on the inside there, and he skidded, but maintained his position on the course. Now the flatter section. The transition between upper Thruway and the final pitch of Draper's Drop. As he comes down, Draper's. And let's see how that red gate treats him. Not bad. Not bad, better than the first couple of skiers. And now to the finish.
And Albert Ortega now across the finish line, and he's going to take the lead with a 59.07. Your new leader
to the position of being the leader now, 59.07 seconds, and he's got a healthy lead of 0.4 over Klinsky, and Monty is third. Andre Moser, as we give you rapid fire action here. Moser, 21, studies economics. He was 14th place last month in the Europa Cup giant slalom. He tried to bring some of those turning skills to the Super G here at Whiteface Mountain. Moser has the fastest intermediate time up on top. Let's see if he can carry that all the way down now. That is a good sign for him if he can maintain. Here's Moser coming through.
For the strike, we'll take a look at it on the clock. It's going to be good enough for second place.
He goes to second place. 59.39 seconds. Trailing Ortega by 0.3 at this point. From the Czech Republic, David Kubeš, a 20-year-old. He was 10th last month in a FIS Super G in Austria. A little bit inside, almost cost him, but he recovered nicely. So important to ride that outside ski, especially up on those slick steeps. Now onto the flat section. This is a section that the recreational skiers love. The top and bottom, not so much. at the top of the Draper's drop pitch. Pretty good execution there on that bump at the red gate. And he's into the finish.
Red gate just to far Looker's right. Keep an eye on that. That could definitely be a bit of a wrinkle thrown at the
waiting for an update here on the scoreboard. As we move right along, Loic Schaubler of Switzerland actually attends Westminster College in Salt Lake City. So in a sense, he's sort of on home soil. He got a little bit inside there, but again, corrected himself. A 22-year-old freshman. Trying to make those final turns above the gate, get those skis pointed into the fall line to accelerate. Schaubler comes down.
And Schaubler, you will pick up.
Meanwhile, our spectator count continues to increase. This is a holiday weekend in the United States. Monday is Martin Luther King Day. Many people have the long weekend and take the opportunity to go on a little ski holiday, and Lake Placid benefits from that and will be quite busy these next couple of days. And we're seeing some of this along the side of the course here at the finish.
They wanted to give it an opportunity to drain. They were able to scrape it, and they were able to get it flat again. And sure enough, we're back.
From the Czech Republic, Jan Zibistran is now on the course, 24 years old, a 2018 Olympian. A little delay set there by the course setter, John Norton, the executive director of the New York Ski Educational Foundation. Zibistran, 2/10 out at that first timing point. If he's got fast skis, a good aerodynamic position, he could close that gap a little bit. And we'll get another look at his standing here as we come to the second timing point. He's ahead now, 44.70, and he's gone into the lead as we have the last four or five gates left to ski here. Zibistran. Wow.
Look at here and the full set. Oh my word.
Jan Zibistran.
Zibistran from the Czech Republic.
Goes into the lead by 7/10 of a second, bumping down Ortega and Perkins.
And we've got a new leader.
As we said, we anticipate this is going to be decided well into the start list, not early into the start list. As we bring Italian Luca Taranzano onto the course. 25 years old, he has one career podium result. It was last year in the Italian National Championships. Trying to stay compact. Keep that airflow out of his chest. He's half a second behind. And now comes into the last pitch. Draper's drop to the finish. And he's 4/10 out.
With a combined time. We'll take a look at that from Taranzano.
Another Swiss skier is next. This is Eric Weiler, a 21-year-old from Brienz. Good skiing up on top. Trying to get into that tight position every chance he can. He's just a 10th out now at the first timing point. With fast skis here, good preparation on those skis, and a good tuck position, he could close that gap. A little skid there. As now he comes into view of all the spectators that are gathered here along Draper's Drop. Eric Weiler from Switzerland, 4/10 behind in third place.
That's good enough for second place, third place for Eric Weiler.
And Weiler, the combined time of 58.77.
I'm sure his family watching back home at their bed and breakfast in Brienne's. We welcome them to the live stream. Jeremy Mathers, a 21-year-old American from the University of Utah. Mathers, as a freshman, had three top tens and two top fives on the collegiate circuit. Zabistrand's time is the benchmark, but Mathers is off the pace by about 1.4 seconds. Mathers is into the finish here at Whiteface Mountain. 11th place, 1.67 seconds. Jan Zabistrand from the Czech Republic. His lead time is 58.35. Will anybody left in the field go after him? American Jacob Dilling, a sophomore at the University of Colorado. He won his first NORAM race last month at Beaver Creek. So let's see if he carries that good feeling and momentum here to the World University Games at Whiteface Mountain. Again, all we have to do is ask you just listen for that natural sound to impress upon you the firmness of this surface. Three-year-old skier Dylan. Here's another one enjoying the training conditions here the other day. Who wouldn't? A couple of days ago, blue sky, terrific snow. Now the snow's terrific, just not blue sky. Dylan is over a second behind as he comes down Draper's pitch.
The line.
A second and a half behind and into 10th place.
84 for Jacob Dillon. That's going to be good enough for
athletics are just part of the story. Anybody who's on the national all academic team knows about time management. From Switzerland, Gianluca Bohm, 22 years old, a skier from Montana State. Intermediate time. He's 8/10 behind Zabistrand. Again, the object of this course is to max out your speed on the steep and bring it onto the flatter section. Then maintain or try to pick up ground on the flats with good equipment, properly prepared, and then execute these turns right here on the pitch of Draper's Drop. To the finish, a second behind, 8th place. A good effort for Gianluca Bohm of Switzerland. From Slovakia, Jan Sanitrar attends school at the University of Zvolen. He's 21 years of age. a guitar player. And see if he can strum a tune coming down here and put himself in contention. Intermediate time, he's a second and change behind. His teammate Zavistran is in the lead at the moment. Probably figuring every skier that goes by, he dodges a bullet. Now over a second off the pace. He stated earlier that his goal here was a top 15. And we'll see if he's going to be successful in achieving that. He's 13th, 1.6 seconds behind.
That's good enough for 13th fastest. Wearing bib number 23, so a good run here from the middle of the pack from Jan Sonnen.
From Lithuania, Andrei Drukarov, 23 years of age. He moved to Tarvisio in Italy to attend the Bachmann College of Ski. From Lithuania, he moved to Switzerland at the age of 9. Little struggle there on the bottom of the pitch. A pretty good run at the intermediate point, though. He's less than 4 tenths behind. Zavistran is safe at the moment. But he's in the leader's box and not able to do anything about it other than watch and hope. 3 tenths out for Drukarov.
He makes his way down.
And now into the finish. Well, how does this look? Pretty good. Fourth place. About half a second behind Drukarov. Showing a lot here. From Kitzbühel, Austria, Christoph Poe, 19 years of age. Negotiated that critical red gate pretty nicely. And we'll see how he fares going from the steep onto the flatter section. Second intermediate time will come up here shortly. 45.92. He's 1.2 seconds behind our leader, Zavistran. There's that little bump at the red gate on Draper's drop. And Christoph Pohl of Austria.
Just surviving
is 15th, 1.6 seconds behind.
Fastest time of the day for Christoph Pohl out of the 27th start position.
There's our current leaderboard. Zavistran, 4 tenths ahead of Taranzano and Weiler. As we go to France's Jeremy Lagier, he will turn 25 on Monday. And will he have an early birthday present? A little bobble there at that critical red gate. But he's in good shape. He was actually fifth in the NORAM slalom race just last week at Burke Mountain in Vermont, and then made the trip over. Lagier chasing Zavistran, and how is the chase going here? He's 1.1 seconds out at the second timer. And now the red bump. Okay.
3 gates to go now.
And here's Jeremy Lagier. His finish time, 59.97. He's 1.6 behind Zavistran. Here are our medal winners. Jan Zavistran wins the gold.
The day belongs to Jan Zavistran.
Italy's Luca Taranzano, silver medalist. The bronze goes to Eric Weiler of Switzerland. From Lithuania, fourth place, Andrei Drukarov. A great race for him. And we're awaiting just the last of the logistical details to be put together on the mascot ceremony. And Eric Weiler, there he is. There's the bronze medalist from Switzerland. The Swiss team is benefiting among its coaches here, longtime men's World Cup coach Carl Fresner. And anytime you can tap into that kind of knowledge and experience, it certainly is helpful for the young skiers. And maybe this is a result of that. Luca Taranzano from Italy wins the silver medal.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, finishing in first place, and the champion for the men's Super G, representing the Czech Republic, put your hands together for Jan Zavistran.
Jan Zavistran, the gold medalist from the Czech Republic. And these three athletes will be at Mintz Park for the medal ceremony tonight. And they'll get to celebrate this
ladies
all over again.
Here are
Zavistran gets Adirondack Mac.
From the Lake Placid 2023.
And that is the mask. And actually all three get Adirondack Mac.
Super G.